Does the Costco membership make sense for individuals? Normally, most people use the membership to try to sneak in friends and extended family. But as long as you're someone who's willing to cook and you have space to store all your stuff, membership might make sense. Before we start, like, share, and subscribe to my channel if you enjoy my content, and I'll make sure that after this video, you'll have a delicious rotisserie chicken waiting for you to purchase inside Costco. So the usual response from Canadians is that they're too broke to buy membership because of the crazy Toronto rent. Just kidding. Usually the response I hear is that they can just use a $60 membership cost to buy food from regular grocery stores, or they see no reason to buy in bulk if the food will rot anyways. For Costco to be worth it, you have to generate enough savings from Costco purchases compared to other places that you would normally buy from. So it's actually very easy to make these savings from Costco. There are four ways you can do this. The first is that you can add a secondary cardholder to your account for no additional cost. You know, if there's someone else, like a friend or a family, you know, posing as living under the same address, you can just fake this, by the way. You can split the cost with them, and they also get a membership to Costco. This way, you get your membership cost cut in half, and more chicken will die on the rotisserie. Second is in-store purchases. From the amounts that you spend on groceries and non-perishable stuff, I noticed that you would roughly get 50 to 100% more in volume. So either you can spend less or you could receive more for your dollar spent. If it's non-perishable stuff, I would just buy more on discount and store it away. Now here are some examples. I noticed that rotisserie chicken is $8 at Costco, but you normally find it $12 elsewhere. Chicken drumsticks. This big pack is $15, whereas other places it's $15, but you have half the amount. Oatmeal, there's two bags in that box for $7. Normally one of those bags would cost $6 elsewhere. Also, if you're there enough, they'll have additional benefits, like discounts on some of the items that I mentioned. Sometimes the discounts can be even higher depending on your purchase. So say if you spend $200 per month for in-store items at Costco. I think that on average, the bulk buying advantage that you get would easily be the same as buying $300 worth of stuff at other places. At $100 a month in savings, you would already make back the $60 membership fee in your first month of spending. The third method is if the Costco location you go to has a gas station, then you can save there too. The fuel is roughly 7 cents cheaper than other brands. So I would say on average, if gas is $1.15 per liter in Toronto right now, and the average person spends $200 per month on gas at that price, at Costco, you would save $12 per month, which is $144 per year. The only problem is that there's a good chance you're probably waiting 15 minutes in line because it's so busy half the time. But you're probably doing nothing productive anyways, so you can be on your phone and watch more of my videos while you wait. Fourth is that the Costco Capital One MasterCard helps to accelerate savings through cashback. Just the credit card alone, I find, can justify the membership costs. For instance, the gas cashback is 2%. Now, if you're already spending $188 per month at Costco, and you do this over the course of a year, you're saving $45. For dining, it's 3% cashback. If you're spending $250 per month on dining, over the course of a year, you're saving $90. In total, your cashback is around $135. So what's the total savings for a regular membership? First, you have a secondary card holder for $30. Then you have in-store savings at $100 per month for 12 months, which is $1,200. Then you have fuel savings at $12 per month for 12 months, which is $144. Then you have your cash back from the credit card for gas and dining, which is roughly $135 per year. And after the cost of regular membership of $60, the total savings you get is $1,449. In fact, let's make it an executive membership because the investment is even better. You personally take on the additional $60 to upgrade and become an executive. You won't need to split that cost with your friend. Otherwise, they will just ditch you and find another friend to do their membership. And then Costco would turn into a Ponzi scheme. What you get as an executive is a 2% reward on in-store purchases, which is equivalent to a 2% cashback. So if in-store, you're spending $200 per month, at a 2% reward, you're getting $72 per year. But remember your friend who's the secondary cardholder? Guess what? You get the in-store cashback from their spending too. So if they spend $200 per month too, then as a primary cardholder, you get an additional $72. So what's the overall savings on Costco as an executive membership? First, you get your regular member savings of $1,449. Then you get your in-store cashback of $72. Then you get your friend's in-store cashback of $72. Then you have to pay the executive membership upgrade of $60. And your final savings is $1,533. Now the savings can be higher because I'm being super conservative. There's a good chance that you or your friend will buy something expensive like clothes, furniture, electronics, or jewelry. And that all adds to the 2% reward. If you and your friend combined spend $250 per month in store already, in a year you make back your $60 upgrade cost back from the reward. So is Costco membership worth it for an individual? Yes. So when is it not worth it to get a membership? One, you either waste too much food. Two, you spend too much. Or three, you have no vehicle. So my take on the food, I know that people usually go to Costco for bulk buying. It's good for feeding multiple families or multiple people. But for individuals, I feel like it's a good opportunity to try different recipes, maybe freezing some of the food for another occasion. It's good for meal prepping. If, say, you're someone who's calorie deficient, it's a good chance to eat more. It's also a good way to stock up on non-perishables. And it's a good thing to make fewer visits to the store, so you're not always traveling. But if the membership starts causing you to buy even more stuff than you normally would, because, you know, there's just so many good deals, then you should really assess your membership or cut back on the purchases. I tried a few times to go to Costco to do my errands through public transit, and it was a real pain because of the amount of stuff I had to carry. Also, by Uber and Lyft, it was starting to get expensive. So at the time when I didn't have a car, I didn't feel that Costco was really worth the effort. So if you really liked what I had to say today, like the video, share it, and subscribe to my channel, and I'll be posting more of this stuff in the future.